so much.
Thanks, Kaylee.
We move now to the kitchen for some, basically, some time-saving tips that any experienced chef will agree. Poor quality knives can make cooking far more difficult than it needs to be. And Chef John Paul, I'm going to welcome you, and then I'm going to step out of the way and let you handle this from here.
Well, everybody's done this,
yes.
Okay? It's the giant block of knives.
Mm-hmm.
And today I'm going to tell you how to keep them sharp.
Well, you get to it. I'm going to go hang out over here and watch it from afar, okay? I have the greatest confidence in you.
Well, this is it. This everybody had to have one. It was a wedding present, a Christmas present, something, and it was the giant block of knives. And you got the giant block of knives, didn't you? And then when you started using it, you said, oh my God, these are the sharpest knives I've ever had. So you used the big one. That was really good until it got dull. And then you went down to the next size one. And then, well, I used that until that got dull. And then I went down to an even smaller one until that got dull. And before you know it, all your knives are dull and you're cutting a roast with this. Okay, so today, what I want to do is explain to you what it takes to sharpen a knife, but really what makes a good knife to start with. Well, in this block over here, I have something called carbon stainless knives. Now, the last knife that I pulled out is a traditional old-fashioned stainless steel knife. And it looks real shiny, and it looks real beautiful. But because it's pure stainless steel, it's too hard to sharpen. So when you buy it, it's going to be really sharp, but as you use it, it's going to get dull, and you're never going to be able to put a new edge on it. When you move upscale, all right, a lot of the German knife companies, Henkel, Wusthof, there's a lot of fine knives out there. This is a carbon stainless knife, which means that it has stainless steel, so it's going to stay nice and shiny, but it has carbon steel, which is soft enough to sharpen. So these are the knives you really want to go out and purchase. Spend the money. Now, if you can't afford the big block of knives, you're going to find that 95% of what you need to do, you can do with these two knives right here, a chef knife and a paring knife. So what do you need to do to sharpen? Well, basically, anything that's harder than the steel on the knife is going to sharpen your knife. When I was just a little Chef John Paul and I was working in restaurants, there was this Chinese restaurant next to us, and these guys would come out and they would sharpen their cleavers on the curbstone. They would actually squat down and start sharpening their cleavers. I'd never seen any of that, right on the street. Well, then I remembered my grandmother actually used to use the bottom of a ceramic dish because the ceramic is actually harder than the steel. So you can actually use a plate. You don't have to spend $1 billion as long as it's harder. Now, there are a couple products out there I want to turn you on to. This is a handheld sharpener, and it basically works by dragging your knife through here. It holds it at a consistent angle. Now, the thing that I don't like about this knife is, because it's so rough, about the sharpener, is it really cuts grooves into the blade. So this guy, I'm going to put off to the side and don't care for it. Over here, this is an electric sharpener. It tends to be pretty expensive, anywhere from $100 to $300, depending on where you get it from. Now, I used to use this, but the problem I had with it is it took way too much steel off. So if you're not that experienced with sharpening knives, you might tend to press down a little too hard, and you'll actually ruin your knife and take off too much steel. This one down here is one of my absolute favorites. Now, we talked about the ceramic. Well, this is the same ceramic that's on the bottom of that bowl. And the cool thing is it's at an angle, so all I have to do is pull my knife through. But my absolute favorite is a plain old stone. Now, you can pick these up just about anywhere. Now, when you're working with a stone, the thing you need to remember, keep it at a 20-degree angle when you sharpen it. So that's 90. I know you never thought you were going to use this geometry again. 90 degrees, half of that is 45, half of that is 20. So approximately there, and just pretend like you're cutting a slice of cheese off the top of a block, and just go back and forth. Add a little bit of oil and sharpen it. Now, plan on getting frustrated a little bit, but this is really the best way to get the edge on your knife. So, as a recap, what have we learned? Spend the money on good knives. Get carbon stainless steel knives. Go out, buy a decent stone. And then when you're done, that funky thing at the end, that's for honing. That won't make your knife sharp. It'll bring back an edge that's already there. Kaylee?
I'm really impressed, I gotta tell you. By the way, if you wanna check out a great restaurant, go to Le Cole. It's at the Scottsdale Culinary Institute there in Scottsdale, the corner. I believe it's Camelback and Hayden, right?
Yes, yeah.
It's a great little place. 480-990-3773.